Resistors can be broadly classified into two categories. One is wire bound resistors. The other one is carbon resistors. These resistors are used to make low resistors that is fraction of ohm to few hundred ohms. Fraction of ohm to few hundred ohms. Carbon resistors are made for higher resistances of the order of 1 kilo ohms. These are made from alloys like manganese, constantin, nichrome. These are made up of carbon. Why we prefer these alloys, manganese, constantin and nichrome? Because the resistance of the above alloys does not change. These are insensitive to temperature. This is the reason why standard resistors are made by this manganese, constantin and nichrome. Carbon resistors are used widely. These are wire bound resistors. The value of this is 2 ohm, a 5 ohm resistor. This is also another 5 ohm resistor. These are all wire bound resistors. On these resistors, we will talk about these lines now. The color code says it begins with black then brown then red orange yellow green blue violet gray white and 3 more bands of gold color, silver and no color. It is the series of the colors. Black, the value of black color is 0, 1, 2, red is 2, 3, yellow 4, green 5, blue 6, violet 7, grey 8, white 9. We will talk about this gold, silver and no color just little later. It starts from black, ends with white. That means there are total 10 digits, single digits. Therefore, these colors, 10 colors are taken and these are numbered like this. The top one is black, the last one is white. So that means all other colors are in between black and white. Now, if you observe from this violet to red, in your lower classes, you would have studied the colors of the rainbow are the colors white light is allowed through a prism. It will be split into 7 colors. So these colors will form a spectrum, and to remember that you would have read this mnemonic as Vibgayar. If you observe this, except indigo, all other colors are of the same order. V, I is not there, B, G, Y, O, R. Vibgayar, it follows. Next, you already know these colors, violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Same is the colors here. Now, actually 10 digits are to be taken, and here 7 colors, out of which we have taken out indigo. We have now 6 colors. So 2 black and white, so 8. Now 2 more colors are to be inserted. For that, brown and grey is the logic behind the color code. Now, to remember this thing, we again form a mnemonic. If you take the first letters, B, B for black, B for brown, so these are the first letters. So here you can remember this as B.B. Roy of Great Britain has very good wife. V for very, G for good, W for wife, with a gold silver necklace. B.B. Roy of Great Britain has very good wife with gold silver necklace. So now you can start with 0, this is 9, and you can write all other numbers. Again, you must not be confused whether this be for black, blue or brown. So black always comes first, because all other colors are adjusted between black and white. Next, this be Vibgayar order, it is blue. Therefore, this should be the remaining B, that is brown. And here, this G is, it is in the pattern of Vibgayar, therefore it's green. This G must be grey. So no confusion should be there. Now, what is the use of this thing? Some bands of colors. Let these bands be red. This is green. And this is orange. And this is silver. Now, how to read the value? Before calculating the resistance, we will have to talk about this one. Gold means its tolerance is 5%. Suppose if the 100 is the reading of the resistance, then it can go up to 105 or 95, plus or minus 5%. Silver is up to 10%, silver color. If no color, that is there is no fourth band, then it can go up to 20%, the tolerance values. Now, how to calculate the value of given resistor? Now, red. What is the corresponding digit for red? 2. After red, it is green. So, we have to write the corresponding digits for the first two bands, and it should be multiplied by 10 to the power of third band, orange, that is 3, and here silver, this is 10%. So it is 25 kilo ohm with a tolerance of 10%. I hope you got how to write the value of resistance when you know the color bands. Now, the problem can be given in a reverse way also. Suppose if I say 0.5 kilo ohms plus or minus 20. Now, tell me the colors to be present on the resistance. Of course, 1.5 immediately you must write this 1.5 into 10 to the power of 3 ohms plus or minus 20. Now this is nothing but 1500 or 1.5 into 10 square plus 20%. So 1 means it is brown. 5, it's green. 2, it is red. Now this 20% means no color. So now that resistance would have only 3 bands. The first one with brown, second one with green, and third with red. So in this way, the numericals can be tackled. If the colors are given, you must be able to write the resistance. If the resistance is given, you must be able to understand the colors. Okay, now let's talk about resistance in different forms. You can see this resistance in the form of a wire. This is a standard carbon resistor in the form of a coil. This is called variable resistance, which is also known as rheostat. And then this is resistance box, through which you can change the resistance, but not continuously. You can change the resistance at some fixed values. So you can observe there are some values written here. So when we take out the plugs, you can understand that is the resistance kept in the circuit. Now first let me explain the function of this wire. Now here in this you can see that I connected a bulb in series with the resistance coil.
Now I have applied 2 volt, but still the bulb is not blown. That means the current that is reached to the bulb is not enough. Now let me apply for 4 volt. Now you can see the brightness of the bulb. It is a bit dimmer. Now let me apply for 6 volts. So now you can see the bulb brightness is more than the previous case. Again we can go for 8. So the main function of resistance here is to control the current. So this coil is offering near about 4 ohms resistance. Now in this place of 4 ohms, I will be attaching a resistance coil. This resistance coil is of 50 ohms. So naturally I have to give more potential difference across the bulb, then only it can glow. So now let me try with the 6. Even last time the bulb was blown at 6. But now even after applying 8 also, it is. So the potential difference that is given through this resistance coil is not enough to light the bulb. Now let me reduce to show the action of this resistance coil. Now let me take 20 ohm and let me try whether the bulb glows or not. See, now at 8 volt the brightness of the bulb is this. Now if I increase 10 volts, so this the brightness is increased, and again I can increase up to 12 volts. So the resistance coil controls the current. Here if you look at this one, it is 6 volt. At 6 volt the bulb is glowing with very little intensity. The bulb is blown. Now I can increase by increasing the current by applying the potential difference. Now this is the second variety of the resistance. Now let me explain the functioning of this resistance box. So resistance box can be operated at different resistances. So here, now as such there is no plug is taken out, the resistance nothing, zero is connected across this one, almost all zero. Now let me take out, this is 1 ohm, 2 ohm, 2 ohm, 5 ohm and so on. So when I take this resistance plugs out, then you can see the brightness of the bulb. So you can observe the brightness of the bulb is continuously decreasing. Now almost all it is not glown. Now let me increase the potential difference. Now it is there. Now let us do the reverse of it. Let us decrease the resistance. You can see the intensity of the bulb is increased. So at different values we can operate this resistance box, but this resistance box can be varied at fixed intervals. So you can see that there are some values written here. This can be operated from 1 ohm to I think 5000. With the combination of resistors you can increase more than 10,000 ohms also. Now the next one, through which we can continuously vary the resistance, that is nothing but rheostat. So rheostat function, let me explain. In rheostat one, sliding key will be there. This is the sliding key, and then see, when the sliding key at this position, the bulb is not glowing with larger intensity. Gradually I am sliding this one so that the brightness of the bulb is increased. So here it is varying resistance not with fixed intervals, but any interval we can operate. So this is called sliding key. This apparatus is called rheostat and this is called sliding key. And then when I move this one, you can see the bulb, brightness of the bulb is increased. So this is the function of rheostat.